Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to this episode of Blue Room Stories. Today's episode is a bit special because Soila and I are going to be doing separate sessions. I'll be talking on my experience, she'll be talking on my experience. So we are not seated together, so this is the good part, she's not there to collect my story. Not there to tell me, don't say it, babe. Let me tell you guys how our vlogs go. Nimongia, then I say something sensitive. Why are you putting that in there? So I have to, yeah. So today I have liberty. I'm a teacher, for those of you who know me. I teach art, but a lot of my work in teaching is very illustrative. So today I have a few things that I want to illustrate to you. Number one, I have half an onion. I have duct tape. Is this duct tape? It's tape. That's all you need to know. It's black. I have a phone there. I have a pillow. And I have soda. Now the soda is mine to drink.
Babe, I...
And you have to salivate back at home. Anyway, on serious matters now. We are now currently 21 months. 21 months. We are an elephant. Currently 21 weeks pregnant. We are currently 21 weeks pregnant. And so I'm just here to tell you how to survive the first and the second trimester. We are still in our second trimester. So I want to speak to you on how to survive the first and second trimester as the husband. As the husband. Now, first things first, I just want to speak to the men. Now, if you're a man and you're watching this video is for you, or if you're a lady, you might want to watch this video for your man. Now, one problem that men have is that whenever we don't like being in a situation where we don't know how to control, we don't like being in a situation where we don't know what to do. So when men find themselves in such a scenario, this expresses itself a lot in pregnancy. Whether you're married or not, you get this chick pregnant and all of a sudden you're panicking, you're not planning for it, so the automatic thing to do is to what? Is to bail, is to avoid responsibility. Now, this is a common thing, but it's not right, men. So, it's not a good thing to do. It's a default setting, but it's not good. The best thing you can do is be there for that lady. Just take responsibility, take care of that lady, take care of that kid. Because you're responsible. Simple as that. So I'm just here to tell you how some of the things that I've experienced in my first and second trimester about my wife. I've seen parts of her that I never thought existed. Number one, so men, remember this video is for you. So I'm just giving you tips on how to understand your lady and how to handle her throughout the pregnancy session. First and second trimester, expect the following. Exaggerations. My friend, things will be exaggerated. I remember when Soila first learned she was pregnant. And, for her, it was the opportunity for her to get me to do things that I would not normally do. It was her opportunity for her to take advantage of her current scenario before the 9 months elapse. So I'll tell you what Soila used to do. So Soila has just learned she's pregnant. She's... I will record this for posterity. She's just like 3 weeks old. Now guys, 3 weeks at a dengu ni kubwa. There's literally no belly there. But Soila is going to be like, oh, this is how small the belly is.
Just give it a
I can see a boxer there.
So this is how small the belly is. Literally there's nothing. But Soila is going to be like, hey, man! expect exaggerations. She'll exaggerate sometimes about how bad her body is feeling. Sometimes her body really is feeling weird, but the exaggeration in which she'll bring forth. So expect those things to happen. Right now, I usually call her Bazokizo because there's this thing. Apparently, when children get pregnant, there's a time when their hips and their thighs start.
She's working out.
Yeah, so she's been working out. So there's this new working stage. She has an akwanga too. So if you watched Bazokizo, that's exactly as it looks. Akwanga too. Hey babe, hey, hey. So now there's this. When I see her. Now get a babe, no, like a bitch, can I come?
Are you okay?
Secondly, there's this thing about the pillow. So apparently, doctors have pregnant women, there's a way they're supposed to sleep with a pillow on their side. You know, me, I'm the kind of person who, because we live in a very cold place, so sometimes I would snuggle up to Soila and grab her so that I gather warmth as we're sleeping. Now, there's this pillow thing. If I may just. So now you'll have to just demonstrate this pillow. So now. So you know, we've got this pillow here. So now you've got this pillow here. So she's sleeping with this pillow. She's basically in a cocoon of pillow. So she's sleeping. Me, in my usual fashion, I'll come to bed at around what time? 1 or 2 a.m. So I come to bed and I'm like, ah. Let me go to where the warmth is. Guys, I'm trying to grab and there's a whole layer of pillow around. So I have to just find a way of squeezing those pillows, getting my way back. Guys, I used to love pillows, not anymore. Currently they are my arch enemy because of, I don't get warmth. I don't get warmth, guys. It's insulating between me and my wife. I don't like that. I like going to where she is because that's where the good stuff is. But now, I have to deal with pillows. So if your husband and you are anticipating for your wife to get pregnant, prepare for the pillow, guys. Prepare for the pillows. There's this thing called the covard syndrome. Covard, as it's written, covard syndrome. So apparently it's actually a real thing. I thought it was just in my head, but it's actually a real thing whereby the husband begins to experience some of the things that the wife is feeling. Like there are times I'll just feel nauseated. I normally don't feel nauseated unless I'm sick. But all of a sudden I'll feel nauseated and then I'm like, hey, Soila, how are you feeling? Then she'll be like, I'm also feeling nauseated. I'm like, that's weird. I don't think it's normal for me to experience your symptoms as the lady. But apparently it's actually a real condition. I don't know if it's psychological or it's biological, I don't know, but it happens. So there are times a husband can feel some of the symptoms of pregnancy that the woman feels, the fatigue, all those things. I think it's the whole thing of being one, eh? I think when you become one, it expresses itself in very many ways. Then there are the obvious things, guys. There's the pregnancy brain. You've heard the women talking about pregnancy brain. You've heard them talking about mommy brain, whereby their mind is just scatterbrained. They cannot remember things as fast as they would. Their mental processing is not as fast as they would. And you have to be very patient with her during this time, because sometimes if you don't understand what's happening, you can become annoying. Or rather, you can become annoyed, not annoying. Whereby you would want her to do certain things, and then you come back a few hours later, did you do? Oh, you told me to do it. So I've been dealing with a lot of that. And at least for me, I knew beforehand that this is something that happens, so I've not been as reactive to her. The other thing that you need to be ready for is the mood swings. Guys, you cannot escape the mood swings. And don't blame her as well, because pregnant women, when they are going through these things, even them, they don't understand what's happening to them. Or sometimes they don't really have control. They just realize when it has happened and they're like, oh shoot, I shouldn't have done that. So that used to happen very early, especially in our first trimester. But one thing I love about my wife is that she listens. I just call her and come here, hey babe, you know you've been behaving like this, and I understand that it's pregnancy, but I think you just need to be sensitive. And she's changed much. So I can't really call that a complaint that I've had for a long time, but it's something you need to look out for. Food aversions. Hey, Now this is where Soila has taken advantage of. There was a time, especially in our first trimester, when they get tired. Really, they say the first trimester is the most delicate, and the body really goes through a lot of rapid changes. And I remember our first trimester, Soila was very. She would get tired quite a number of times. She would get tired really quickly. And so I just decided to be a nice, loving husband and come here. You know what? There's a week I told her, you know what? For this week, you just rest. I'm going to cook for you. Of course, she was happy. Now, let me tell you guys, I had no idea what I was getting myself into. But Skwile ataenda kitchen achungulie. The day she'll peep in the kitchen, then she'll see ugali, mboga, mayai. Who? Soila. That's the day you'll be like, I don't know, I feel like puking. What are you making there? She's already seen. I don't know she's seen. I know there's something you're just making there that is making me feel awkward. And I'm like, oh, okay, so what do you want? I don't know, I feel like some pizza, some nyama choma. One thing I really love about my wife is I usually hear, you know, pregnant women sharing their experiences. Oh, when I became pregnant, my face had these all spots. And did you want what? And my nose became big, I looked like a whale and all those things. And I was like, oh my gosh. And so when I got pregnant, I was waiting for all those extreme cases. But apparently she's been very, I don't know, I found her quite attractive throughout her pregnancy period. She's been really good looking, despite the fact that she has a bump. But that bump is disciplined. It knows where to stay. It's not going every other places with the body. So for me, I thank God she's had a very nice pregnancy. She looks really beautiful. She looks really wonderful. She's very attractive. Her face is smooth. Her smile is brighter. Her eyes are wider. Her nostrils. She breathes well. And one thing I've really learned that just puts her in a good place is me being there. Sometimes it's not really that she wants me to do something. She just wants me to. Puts her at a very nice place. She's very relaxed, she's at rest. Yeah, and I think for pregnant women, the psychology plays a huge factor, even sometimes more than the food. So if you're a dude and your chick is pregnant, your wife is pregnant, just be there. Just be there. You don't have to figure everything out, just be there. Let them see that they are not alone in this thing. Yeah. Cheers.